Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this edition of Programming Wizards. Today we're going to look at how to show a pop-up menu when a JTable cell is clicked. Okay, when the header cells of a JTable columns are clicked, like this is what I'm talking about. You can see when I click the particular header cells, you can see we have a nice J pop-up popping up. So welcome, we get started. Yeah, so people, as you can see, I have an empty class here. Now what I shall do is simply shall extend the JFrame, because this is something that we want to display in a GUI. So I'll come create a constructor, say public J, not J pop-up menu, J table pop-up. Okay, then inside our constructor we shall call super and then pass the title of our program there. So I'll just call it JTable pop-up that way. I'll just give it that short name. Then after that one, guys, we'll need a class that shall represent our data. So I'll create a class known as team. We want to show teams in this program. So the first thing, I shall give it the columns. Now the first column shall be position of the team. The second column shall be what the name of the team. Okay, now the second one shall be the name of the team. The third one shall be the head coach. So I just case string name. Let me just add the modifier, private string name, then head coach, then points. This shall be the columns for our table. Okay, in fact they shall represent the data that we shall be adding. Now we come and create a constructor, so say public team. Then the first thing that we pass in our constructor, of course, is the position, then the name. Okay, now as you can see, public team, string team, name, head coach, points. Okay, now this shall be the columns. Now I'll just come inside our constructor and assign them this dot position equal to position, this dot name equal to name, this dot head coach equal to head coach, and so forth. Then after that one, we shall come and generate our header, our getters. I'll copy paste this one, come over to source and come over to generate getters. Yeah, now as you can see, our public string, these are our getters. Public string get position, return position, get name, return name, get head coach. Okay, these are our getters. Now after that one, we are through with our class that shall represent our team. So what we'll do now, we shall create our table model. So let me just separate this one, then come and say a table model. So to do our table model, we just create a new class. I'll call it a model. So let me just say a class model, then extends abstract table model. Then obviously we have to add the unimplemented methods, which are get value at int. This one, the first one is row, then this one is colon, then get row count, get colon count. Now inside our model class, the first thing that we shall do is that we shall create the column headers. I don't know whether I've spelled it right. Now I'll say final string, I'll call it column headers. Then I'll pass over an array to our column headers. Now the first one shall be position, then name, then head coach, then points, then qualified. That shall be our column headers. Okay, then the second one, I shall create a data type for all the columns. Types. Remember, using this model, the data type shall determine the type of column. Data type for columns. So I'll come and say final class, an array of class. Then I'll call it column types. Then I shall pass first one string dot class, that will be the position. Second one, which will be the name, will also be string dot class. The third one, string dot class also. Then I'll add another string dot class and a boolean dot class. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 5, there are five. Now this one shall determine the type of rows columns that shall be constructed. Then what next? The next thing that we shall do, we shall create a vector that shall be holding our data. So I'll say vector to hold our data. So come and say vector data equal to new vector. I'll just remove this one. Then we shall now create a method that shall be responsible for adding a new team. So let me just comment it and say add new row stroke team. So I say public void add team. Now inside our add team method, we shall pass a team object. Remember, we created the class known as team. So then we shall add it to the vector. So data dot add, then a team. Then say fire table rows selected, rows inserted, not selected. So then pass data dot size minus one. Then data dot size. Sorry. This one first of all should be size. Then minus one. Then that method add new team. It should be responsible for adding a new team. Now what we shall need to do, remember there are some methods that we implemented here. So int get column count. Now when we want to return the column count, what we simply do, we come here, okay, column headers dot length, and that is what we pass our as our column count. What about row? Row is also simple. Just come and say data dot size. Okay, that is the vector, the size of the vector. Now the next thing that we need here, we come here, if you want to find an object at a specific row at a specific column, okay, that is, we want to return an object from a specific cell. Now the first thing that we shall do, we shall create a team object. So say team T equal to data dot element at, remember the data is a vector, so we pass the row, then we simply cast it to team. That one shall return us with us for us a team object from the vector. Now we use an if else statement. If col equal to 0, that is if it is in this first column, we simply return t dot get position, not points, position, because remember the very first element was the position. Now what about if col equal to 1, we return t dot get name. That is if it is in the column number 1. If it is in the column number 2, we return head coach. Then column number 3, we return points. Otherwise, we return null. So say else return null. Okay. Now we can also add a method here. So I can say public boolean to determine if the thing is editable or not. Is cell editable, then inside it we shall pass the row and the column positions. No, this one I'll just give it false, but if you like you can make yours true. If you make it true, it shall be editable. Then we are through with our model and our class, team class that shall represent the data. Now we come to our main class. Remember we had already created the... We have our main class. Now what we come to our main class, the first thing that we do is that we create our object, our model object. So say create model object, and with that one it's simple, just say model m equal to new model. Then we also need to create our JTable, so say final, because remember we want to display stuff in JTable. So say final JTable, I'll call it table equal to new J table. Then inside our J table we pass our model M. Okay, so that the J table is constructed as per our specification. Now after creating a model, our model object, and adding it to the J table, we now need to add rows to the model. So let me say add rows to model, which is simply a matter of saying adding the specific teams to the model. Now the first one I'll say team m dot add team. Remember we created the method add team. Now the first thing what we shall pass, we shall pass a team instance. Then as we pass the position, then the name of the team, then after the name we add the name of the head coach, then after the name of the head coach we pass the points, then we pass the boolean, that is if the team qualified. Now what I shall do, I'll just copy paste now this one and reuse it. So you can see add team, this one should be small team, team the same to this one, a team, and finally this one team. Now you can see the positions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then the teams, head coaches, points, and whether they qualified or not. So after that one, the next thing, we will come to and create our J pop-up. Remember we want to show a J pop-up. So say create a J pop-up. Now to create a J pop-up, just say final J pop-up menu. I'll call it pop equal to new J pop-up menu. Then the first thing we create, we add an item, J menu item. So say new J menu item. Then inside it we pass the name of the item, that is the text that shall be displayed in the pop-up. So this one I shall leave it item 1. Now I'll copy paste this one and read. So we shall just have item 2. Okay, J menu item 2, and then item separator, then item 3. Then after that one, now we shall come and create the headers for our J table. Table headers. And that one we just say final J table. Sorry. Final J table header, then I'll call it header equals to table dot get table header. Then after creating it, now what we come to do, we add the mouse listener, because we want this thing to happen in the header. We want that when the user right clicks the header, then the pop-up is shown. So come and say header dot add mouse listener, then we pass the mouse adapter. So new mouse adapter. Well, I expected the compiler to generate for me, but let me just type it. So I'll just say public void mouse clicked. This one we are handling the mouse clicked event. Now inside it we shall pass the mouse event. We'll just call it ME. Then inside it, what we shall do says if we shall determine if the user has right clicked. If swing utilities, okay, dot is right mouse button, then we pass the ME, the mouse event. Then if that is the case, then we show the pop-up. Pop-up dot show, and we pass the header. We also pass ME dot get x. Okay, then ME dot get y. Then after that one, let's scroll down. Now the remaining thing is the our J scroll pane. Remember, this is a table, so it's appropriate that we add it to a J scroll pane. So create a scroll pane, and by that one I just say J scroll pane. I'll call it pane equal to new J scroll pen. Okay, then remember to pass the table inside the J scroll pen instance. Now then say get content pen. Okay, get content pen dot add, then we add the pen. and probably let's position it. Just say border layout dot center, so that we position it at the center. Now the only thing now remaining is that probably we add some event, okay, some window listener, so that when the user closes the thing, it exits the application. So say add window listener. Now I'll just pass the window adapter. Then I'll say public void window closing. Now inside our window closing, I'll pass window event. This one should be window. Window event. Then we shall exit the system. Now system dot exit. Then we pass 0 as the argument. So that one shall make sure that we shall be able to close our thing. Now after that one, I shall come and create our main method. Remember, we had not created it. So I'll come here and say, actually, where should it be located? No, it's not here. It is after this bracket here. So main method. Now come and say public static void main string args. Then we pass over the arguments. Then the first thing that we need the class instance. So say jtable popup, and then I'll just call it j, give it some nice name like jp, then is equal to new jtable popup. Then jp dot pack, we pack it. Then jp, we set it visible. And guys, I think that one should be through, unless we have an error. Remember, no, I don't see if we have an error. Let's now run our simple program and see. Here it is. Okay. Now you can see, if I right click, you can see we have some very nice pop-up being shown. Okay. If I right click, we have our pop-up menu getting shown. So guys, hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. Please, if you have subscribed to this channel, like this video, comment, please share this video with friends and family. I'm sure they'll like it. And please take care. See you next time.